there's no customers in the store and we can maintain a 6-foot distance between our employees, then yeah, we might slip the masks off, you know, just because they're a little annoying. But while we're in here and there's customers in the store, we're constantly masking, and we've got the, you know, Lysol disinfectant wipes and blah, blah, blah. And is there something I could help you find today, sir?
I'll bet there is.
Oh, good.
The centerpiece on a turntable for 45.
So we have the thing you can put in the 45, or if you see these 45 adapters, and those are the kind that go over the spindle. Yeah.
Flipside Records.
This is the sound.
This is the sound of the summers.
A store full of collectibles, vinyl, new, used. Right there in downtown Clawson, nestled between Royal Oak and Troy, southeast Oakland County, as Todd Fundero tries to survive the pandemic.
I like to think of this as an emporium of escapism. Right? Anything to get your mind off of what's going on around us, right?
Yeah.
We got into the story of Clawson during the pandemic because of Flipside Records, your store in your town, Chris.
Yeah, so Flipside Records is where I've gone to buy my music since I was a teenager. And so to see them post on Facebook, hey, please call us and please buy our merchandise and come pick it up curbside. We need your help, because if people don't start shopping here curbside again, we're not going to be here when the pandemic is over. And they would do Facebook Live videos of, like, he'd hold his phone and flip through a bin of records and, like, just do, like, sort of a virtual browsing experience, basically. A couple weeks into the pandemic, you wrote that Facebook post, basically, come back in or else we won't be here.
Yeah. I mean, and that's the truth, right? It's not a matter of, you know, I can do curbside and people can pick up and stuff, but so that's a constant thing. And, you know, I don't want to be crying a sob story every week and this and that, you know, but I got bills to pay, and I know I have customers that don't want to see me close, right?
Fundero's store has been here for 38 years. Clawson, a city of 2.2 square miles, at the turn of the last century, a stop on the interurban rail that came north from Detroit. It's not clear how Clawson got its name. It said somehow the letter C got in front of a guy named Lawson and it stuck. Clawson boomed in the 50s and 60s. That's when the population peaked. 18,000, 6,000 more than today. For a while it was down, but never out.
I mean, if you look at those early streetcar suburbs, most of them have survived pretty well to the present day. They're still desirable places to live. Their housing stock is in good shape. And part of that is their location, because they're close in, so they got dibs on a good location. But part of it, I think, is also just the way they're laid out and designed.
You know, I remember Clawson in the 1960s, the streetcars were gone, but then they had I-75. You know, you just get off on 14 Mile Road down a couple miles and you were there. And right on the other side of I-75 was the Oakland Mall. And when that came in, that kind of hollowed out the downtown back then.
When I was a kid was when Clawson kind of started to come back and reinvent itself. And they narrowed the roads, widened the sidewalks, and it became this very organic, walkable downtown that was really a fun place to go. And that's a quality that a lot of towns want to cultivate and that a lot of towns basically lack.
It's a push toward placemaking, as urban planners call it, the connection between space and people, providing a sense of, well, place.
Human scale is important, affordability is obviously important, and a sense of place is important. To an outsider, you have to be able to describe it and have the person be able to understand what that place looks like. You have to feel like you fit there in a particular way, I think. I think if you think of the suburbs, does Troy have a good sense of place? I think it really does. It has other advantages, sure, but I think sense of place is not one of them.
14 years ago when we moved in here, Clawson was a drive-through town. It was just a big conduit to I-75.
Leon and Lulu has unique home furnishings, clothes, art, curated hard-to-find things. A destination store like Flipside, where shoppers need to come in and browse. Actually, there are quite a few stores like that in Clawson. Supplies for magicians, comic book collectors. Here you can get your fine yarns and harps. Yes, harps, if you need more than one.
We have things here that nobody else has.
Clawson now is a lot of what it was Clawson then, that very small town family kind of feel. There was a time in the late 60s, 70s where we lost that. You know, when you lose the core of your community, you lose some of your identity. So this is all about making sure we retain that.
Retain and revive. The Clawson Movie Theater closed in the early 1960s. The Ambassador Roller Rink in 2005.
Both buildings were built in 1941. This building as a roller skating rink and the other as a movie theater. So we actually now own the entire entertainment district of Clawson.
Now this operation is helping with Clawson's sense of space. We're looking at how Clawson businesses deal with the pandemic. How will they figure their way out of this economic downturn?
Leon and Lulu is something of a small business innovator, which has become nationally known. They had a lot of in-store events, like art shows and book signings, the kinds of things that they're struggling to figure out how to do again post-COVID. We caught up with Leon and Lulu owner Mary Liz Curtin back in May, when her doors were still shut because of the pandemic, and it would be a few more weeks before they were open again.
We're all scared that we're going to run out of money. We're scared that people are not going to come in. We're scared that too many of them are going to try to come in. We're afraid that when they come in, they're not going to like our stuff. We're afraid that when they come in and they buy our stuff, we won't be able to replenish it because there's supply chain issues. The biggest problem, I think, for every merchant of any kind is we're scared, but we don't know what we're scared of. We don't know how to react to it because it's all completely unknown.
By May, a staff of 40 reduced to a handful. Like Flipside, they were selling online.
Leon and Lulu did not have an online store. We really dedicated everything to a fabulous shopping experience in the store.
Okay.
So we had to learn how to sell things online, and we opened our low-tech web store. So that's brought us into a whole new kind of business that we haven't done before. The curbside pickup, the shipping, it's all new to us. Everything's new to us is the way it's all being handled.
Adding to the stress, last fall, Curtin opened a restaurant in the movie house called Three Cats, small plate farm-to-table fare. Created by veteran restaurant man Matt Prentice, starting to get popular, just in time for the shutdown.
Again, I've never been through this, and I've probably been around longer than 99% of the people in the restaurant business in Detroit today, so I had thought I'd seen everything until now.
Three Cats sold a lot of takeout when the shutdown hit, but it wasn't really enough. Now business is picking up for the restaurant and the store slowly. Estimates have the number of restaurants in Clawson tripling in the past 20 years, but at the corners of 14 Mile and Main, three restaurants sit closed, closed before the pandemic hit. What about that?
Yeah, there was a Vietnamese restaurant on the corner that closed last year, a Pizza Hut that recently closed, although maybe that's not such a loss in a town defined by one-of-a-kind small businesses. But the really big loss was Black Lotus Brewery. Black Lotus had been there since 2006, and along with Leon and Lulu, was one of the really transformative businesses that had really led the resurgence of downtown Clawson. It was such a popular neighborhood spot that One Detroit even filmed a show there last year. So when it closed literally overnight last fall, that was a big shock to the system for downtown Clawson.
Well, it was a shock, but we do have some news. The eyes of Clawson upon them, there are a couple people looking to pick up where the Black Lotus left off.
We believe so much in Clawson that we decided to, frankly, bet everything we own and start this boom truck venture. You know, there's a lot of opportunity for Clawson to grow into something even more amazing.
Andrea and Tyler Williams now have what was the Black Lotus. It's a new restaurant called Puma Chug, and it could open as soon as next month.
Yeah, but what is the outlook going to be for restaurants, and especially new restaurants, that are opening for the first time in this new world of COVID? So that's one of the big stories that we're going to be diving deeper into as we look into one small town's business district during the pandemic.